here. Welcome back to my channel. We are here in Minneapolis for the Wander Writers Retreat, and joining me today to talk about working with editors is the lovely Mandy Lynn. I will link her channel down below, so you should definitely go check her out. But until then, stay right here and check out this video while we talk about working with editors. So when it comes to finding editors, for me, I did the first thing I could think of, and that was I Googled it. And I knew that I wanted to work with a Canadian editor, mainly because for a lot of other things, I was working with people out of the States. And as you guys might know, I live in Canada, so I was paying a lot more money because of the stupid conversion rates. So I wanted to work with someone out of Canada. So I went to the Editors of Canada website. I will link that down below for any of you guys looking for editors out of Canada. And what was really cool about that website is I could put in like kind of what I was looking for in terms of what kind of editing I needed. So like they have all the different kinds, like developmental, substantial, copy editing, proofreading, all that kind of stuff. You could search for different editors. You could also search by location if you wanted like your editor to live close to you. Fun fact, I actually live in the same city as my editor, which is kind of funny. We didn't originally live in the same city, but I ended up moving to where she lived. So we finally got to meet in person. And it was very fun. Yeah, it was kind of cool. I looked through like a lot of different editors' profiles and I checked out their website and finally found one that sounded really good to me. So I reached out to her and chatted a bit. I sent her some sample pages and she edited those and sent them back to me as a sample edit. And I really liked her feedback and the vibe felt right. So I pretty much hired her on the spot and I've been working with her ever since. So that's I got really lucky when it came to finding my editor.
So for my editors for Essence and I and Mercy are different than the ones that I use for She's Not Here. So for Essence and I and Mercy, it went really well with Essence and it didn't go so swell with I and Mercy, so I was kind of at a loss. I'm like, I don't know who to use as an editor. Then I met the lovely Kim Chance, and well, she was like, if you ever need me to edit your book, and I was like, well,
I just might.
I do have a book you need to edit. And you know, I respect her tremendously as an author. She's also been an English teacher. And you know, my book had been through a few different beta rounds. And really all I needed was like, you know, nothing too big. So I was like, you know what? Kim, she can do this. So, you know, I just, honestly, the fact that I respected her so much as an author, it made me work a lot harder on my manuscript to be like, okay, I want to make sure it's like as polished as possible because I don't want Kim to judge me. Yeah, that's how I chose her for She's Not Here.
So when it comes to editing, obviously there's a lot of different types of editing and it can get very confusing. There are a lot of authortubers who talk about the differences of editing, so I'm not going to waste time talking about that today. Or you can Google it. There's so many websites that break it all down for you. My editor for me does all of it except for proofreading. She does offer proofreading, but for some reason, I've always preferred sending my work after I do the professional edit to someone new to go through it. It's just like a brand new set of eyes. So I've used Kim to do proofreading for both Twisted Fate and Twisted Gift, which was really cool. So like I said, I hire someone different to do proofreading after the final round of my edits are done, because obviously proofreading comes last, right before you format the book to make it a real book.
So for She's Not Here, I had betas do basically the big picture stuff, and then I had my editor go through and do the line edits, so line by line, and then she just made any notes if there was anything like wildly outrageous that looked wrong, which there wasn't. So always good. And then of course proofing. So I actually did have Kim do both rounds, which I'll admit I was a little worried about, but I didn't have anyone else. I was like, I trust this person. So I actually, someone from my job actually volunteered to do, like, I don't know if you want to call it final proofing, but just so I could have that brand new, fresh set of eyes.
For sure.
Because that's always super important, because it's so easy to miss anything. But, you know, can never be too sure.
That's very true, yeah. And it's always good to have someone new look at it.
Yeah.
Just because, like, I know when, for Twisted Fate, there were some things that I didn't find until it was published. Wow. And it was just before it was published, so there was arcs, but I had printed a lot of copies already. And so I could and did go back and change it. But the fact that I missed it, my critique partners missed it, my beta readers missed it, my editor missed it, and my proofreader missed it. Like, we're all human, so obviously, like, I'm not holding a grudge against anyone, because even I missed it. But the, like, it's just, it's always great to have new eyes on your work, because the books have a lot of words in them. Like,
a lot. Usually, 80,000 or more.
Yeah, so like it's super easy to miss things. So I find it really important just to have fresh, as many fresh eyes on it as you can. And when I send my manuscript to my editor, she has it for like 3 to 4 weeks. For Twisted Fate, she had it for basically a month. And then for Twisted Gift, it was close to a month. I don't think it was exactly a month. I ended up having to push back when I sent it to her because I wasn't done editing it. I was lucky enough to I have a great editor who was able to work with me and kind of move her schedule around a little bit to accommodate my need for more time, which was lovely. Some editors charge their clients by word count. Mine actually goes by hour, so she tracks the hours that she works on it in like an Excel spreadsheet. And while she takes like a month to edit my book, each week she sends me an update with like her log sheet. Oh, so it's basically like she's keeping a timesheet, like that's because it's her job. So I'm seeing her progress in my manuscript and how much time she's working on it. And she even breaks it down because like she takes time to like write the style sheets and to make notes and stuff like that. So she breaks down everything she's doing just so I see what I'm being charged for, which is nice. Feels good to be kept in the loop about everything. I mean, part of why I self-published is enjoying the control aspect. So it was great that she was sharing pretty much everything with me.
So I'll admit, I actually lost a lot of track of time when it came to editing She's Not Here. So when I sent the manuscript off to my editor, I was basically like, okay, this is the time where I can take to do anything else that's not about the book. And I was like, I have only a few weeks. I think honestly, Kim took like about 2 or 3 weeks each round, and they flew by really fast, so I'm not even sure if that's accurate in terms of timing.
So a lot of people ask me, and I'm sure they've asked you, because we've been doing this for a while, is hiring a professional editor 100% necessary? And my answer is always yes. Because, there's no way around it if you want to publish, especially if you're self-publishing, if you want to publish decent work, you need an editor. It's just, it's a necessary evil, and it is a steep expense, but I think it's one of the most important ones you need. And quite honestly, in my opinion, even if you're like pursuing the traditional route, you want to query an agent, I still think it's beneficial to go through a professional edit on your manuscript. Of course, it's not 100% necessary, because once you land an agent and get a book deal and you have a publisher, they're gonna edit the crap out of it anyways, but honestly, like, to make sure you have the cleanest manuscript possible, I would spend the money and hire an editor. Either way, self-publishing or traditionally publishing, editors are your friends.
They absolutely are. And honestly, you get what you pay for, so if you hire a cheap editor, you're gonna get shoddy work.
Yeah.
And honestly, you would, imagine if you publish a book that wasn't professionally edited. One, people are going to point it out in the reviews. Like,
absolutely.
People aren't stupid. They're going to either see the typos or the huge plot holes or just point out everything wrong with the book that if you had hired an editor, they would have been like, you need to fix this.
Yeah, for sure.
And even worse, so if you decide later on, like, you've published this book and now you want to fix it, now you have to go through the editing process all over again. You just want to do it correctly the first time, because really that's the way it's supposed to work. You don't want to have to like republish a book, because it can be a painful process, because you're just paying all the expenses all over again.
Awesome. So why don't you let us know what you're working on and where we can find you?
So I am working on She's Not Here. It's coming out October 2nd, and I know it's so soon. It's a psychological thriller. If you would like to hear all about it, I'm sure Jesse will leave like links down below, but I am also here on YouTube, Mandy Lynn Vlogs, and everywhere else on social media, Mandy Lynn Writes.
So that's going to be it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you, Mandy, for joining us. I will leave all her links down below, so you should definitely check her out and subscribe to her channel. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel on your way out. If you're new here, I post new writing-related videos every Friday. If there's something you would like me to make a video about, please feel free to leave a comment down below or tweet me. All my social media information is down below, including my author website. And if you would like any information on my books, where to buy them, when they're coming out, all that fun stuff, those links are down below as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you next Friday. Bye! Bye.